Hello, my dear friends. My name is Alberto. Welcome to this episode of AMP for WordPress. In the previous episode, we learned about Core Web Vitals, which are a set of metrics that capture fundamental performance aspects of our site and play a key role in a new ranking factor that is called page experience. We asked the question, how can we achieve the desired threshold for these Web Vitals consistently for our sites? And we concluded that we can take advantage of AMP as a powerful and cost-effective tool to help us achieve our page experience goal, regardless of our technical expertise or the amount of resources we have. In this episode, we are going to talk about what AMP is and what makes it a great tool to help us in our quest to build user-first sites. It's a web framework built purely on open web technologies. HTML, JavaScript, and CSS, that's it. But what makes AMP a great tool is that all the components and the runtime are designed and implemented in a highly optimized way. Now, when you hear the term AMP, it can refer to two related but different things. It can be AMP, the web component framework, which you can use to build great user-first sites, or it can be AMP, the set of ecosystem components which take advantage of the capabilities of AMP to bring great experiences to users on different platforms. One of those ecosystem components is the AMP cache specification. An AMP cache is a kind of free content delivery network, or CDN, for caching AMP documents and making them readily available to everyone. But besides of being just a CDN, an AMP cache ensures that pages served through it are always valid AMP. And it also performs a variety of optimizations to make these AMP pages load so fast that they give the user the feeling that they load instantaneously, and that they love that feeling. Now, the AMP cache specification can be implemented by anyone on any platform that wants to serve AMP pages to their users. Google has one AMP cache, Bing built another one, Cloudflare has another one, and so on. And then there are platforms such as Google Search, Twitter, Pinterest, LinkedIn, for example, that can serve AMP pages to their users if they are available, because they want to bring a good user experience to their users, and AMP gives them that. Now, let's see how AMP helps us directly to achieve the desired Core Web Vitals threshold so that we can ensure great page experiences to our users. The first Core Web Vital we discussed was LCP, which captures the render time of the largest image or text block visible within the viewport of the user. And we know that to provide a good experience, the LCP should occur within 2.5 seconds from the time when the page starts loading. Now, AMP helps quite a bit with LCP in at least two ways. AMP uses a static layout system, which allows it to know the overall layout of pages even before resources are fully loaded. And taking advantage of it, AMP can do something that is called intelligent resource loading, which means loading resources only if they are likely to be seen by the user. Also, when AMP pages are served from an AMP cache, such as Google or Bing's AMP caches, AMP pages can be preloaded and pre-rendered in an efficient and privacy-preserving manner. And these capabilities can take seconds from the load time from AMP pages to the point of making them feel that they load instantaneously. The second Core Web Vital metric that we discussed was First Input Delay, or FID, which measures the interactivity level or responsiveness of our pages. And we know that to provide a good user experience, pages should have an FID of less than 100 milliseconds. AMP helps us on the FID front in at least six ways. First, in AMP, all resources are loaded asynchronously. This means that AMP pages are designed to never block while loading resources. Second, AMP makes extensive use of the Pre-Connect API, which allows browsers to set up early connections before HTTP requests are actually sent to the server, cutting quite a bit of the round-trip latency usually incurred when setting those connections. Third, AMP delays rendering of elements that are not likely to be seen right away by the user. And this reduces the amount of work the site has to do at any given time, keeping it running in a way that it feels instant and smooth. Fourth, AMP implements process chunking, which means that long-running tasks get split into smaller pieces so that the execution of any task does not block the loading of pages ever. Fifth, AMP ensures that all third-party code that runs on our site is properly sandboxed. And it does this by running on secure and independent iframes. This means that slow ads or code-heavy video players won't stop users from actually enjoying the content that you are providing to them. And sixth, AMP takes advantage of the computational capabilities of graphic cards, usually called GPUs, which are commonly available on devices nowadays. For example, it allows only animations that can be run efficiently on GPUs. Now, the third Core Web Vital that we discussed was the Cumulative Layout Shift, or CLS, which measures the visual stability of our pages. And we know that to provide a good user experience, pages should maintain a CLS of less than 0.1. And help us with the CLS metric in at least two ways. First, the AMP static layout system is of great help here again, because AMP knows the location and the size of every element component of the page. It can determine the overall layout of the page before the resources are loaded, and then it can prevent bad CLS values from happening. And also, when dynamic changes to components of a page are needed, AMP allows them to take place only if they are in response to a user interaction with the components. That means that there can be CLS happening on the site, but it is going to be in response to user consent. And AMP provides efficient phone loading. For example, it ensures that there are good fallbacks, that there are no flashes of unstyled content, and so on. And addressing these details improves the user perception of how much shifting there is as our content loads into their devices. Now, this gives us a good sense of what AMP is and all the performance optimizations and performance best practices that it brings to us out of the box to help us in terms of achieving our page experience goal. But there is more. AMP not only helps us to get to the point in which we have page experiences, but also to stay on the path of great page experiences as our site and the web evolve. AMP provides a validation mechanism that helps us to avoid regressions and give us the confidence that we can stay on the fast lane over the lifetime of our sites. And again, regardless of our technical expertise or the amount of resources that we have to invest to maintain our sites. And also, the AMP framework lives and is served from a CDN, and the AMP team ships weekly updates that are delivered without friction to every site in the world using the AMP framework. So this means that in essence, with AMP, you have a whole team of engineers and contributors working for you, helping you to keep your site modern and optimized at all times. So the bottom line is this: there are many, many aspects that we must take into account consistently in order to be able to provide page experiences to our users all the time. And tackling all of them effectively is challenging for most of us. The good news is that we can take advantage of the design principles and capabilities of AMP to help us achieve our page experience goal. If you want to learn more about AMP, please check out the framework site amp.dev and also all the great videos in the AMP YouTube channel, including this one. In the next episode, we are going to discuss what does it take to integrate AMP Content Publisher into the standard WordPress content publishing workflows. Stay tuned, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and enable notifications, and let's make it happen.